You're watching Action News Now. Storm Tracker weather, coverage you can count on.
Now a live look from an Alert California camera, South Fork's lookout over Shasta County.
Chief Meteorologist Howie Gordon is tracking this very, very long summer. I mean, fall, right? Technically fall, Howie, but gosh, 100 degrees out there.
Yeah, I mean, it's still summer around here, so I don't think we've declared fall, even though the calendar wants to tell us that. But yes, we are very much on the hot side. Here's another Alert California camera. Artuis in Glenn County looking at these. If I mess it up, please correct me, Haley, now. But our Artuis shot, Alert California, nothing but blue. And then some agriculture out there getting some human water, because on the green side, it's not green by what's taken place in Mother Nature over the last 5 months. Okay, so a mild night. And I say, again, cooler. But even as we cool down, we're still going to see lots of sunshine and temperatures on the hot side above average. Okay, so a few degrees cooler overnight in the valley, a little more comfy. You can actually probably get that air, open up your windows and get that in your place of residence. Higher ups, little lower as well, with temperatures in the low to mid 40s. But then tomorrow, I know this is not 102 or 101, but we're still mid to upper 90s and 15 to 17 degrees above average for this time of year. Look at the coastal range, the North Mountains, starting to see those temperatures come down to the mid 80s, because we've been pushing 100 in those higher ups. Over on the ridge, look at that, some places coming down to right around 90, then again compared to the mid to upper 90s. Why is this happening dynamically? Because you can't see the high pressure. It's moved off towards the east southeast. Thus, the heat has shifted. Sacramento seeing very intense heat today with some records. But again, that heat has shifted to the south of the area for the most part. But to get closer to the weekend, that high moves closer again. We'll jump up a few degrees. But what's going to happen at the end of the weekend? Those storms from Alaskan origins up there, you're not going to see them breach the area and move down. But they're going to start pushing on this high pressure ridge. They're going to start leaning on it. This high will no longer be at its peak or with its top condition, if you will. So it's going to be a little less of a version of itself. We'll start to cool. But when I say we start to cool, we're just not going to be 103. We might not be 99. We might be 94 or 95 and still very much on the hot side and above average. And pretty much this flow with the high stays here for the rest of the week until maybe about a week from now, as the high continues to weaken and move further away. We'll start to get closer to average temperatures for this time here, but still we're going to remain above compared to where we're supposed to be heading into the third week of fall and second week of October. All right, here's what we have. Look at this. Friday, 97, Saturday, 98. But then next week, okay, so 91, 89, that is still 8 to 12 degrees above average for this time of year, and at the same time, borderline hot. So summer just keeps on going. And I don't mind it, because you know eventually we're going to be, where's the heat when it's cold and rainy out?
Yeah, well.
Hopefully sooner rather than later, though, Howie. But, you know, yeah, it'll get here.
All right. Thanks, Howie.